Hello everyone, this is the fifth video about the topic set, and in this particular video we are going to discuss about the operations in sets. There are three different types of operations which I am going to discuss in this video, along with their definition, their examples and their notations, with lot of practice questions, and in the last there will be a quiz. Okay, so the topic which I am going to discuss in it, like with the operations, they are union, intersection and differences. These are the name of the operations that we can perform on a set. Okay, let's start with the first operation. Its name is union. Okay, so first point is definition. So definition is what? For example, we have two sets or more than two sets, then only we can apply the union operation. So first thing is, there must be either two sets or more than two. Okay, see, I am not going into depth of the formal definition. My main motive is to make you understand the concept behind it. Okay, you can follow the books, you can get the formal information, but if you don't understand it, then it is of no use. So first thing is union operation. If you have to consider it, if you have to find the union of a set, okay, so you need to find two sets. You can find the union of two sets, you cannot find the union of one set or a set. Okay, you have to find the union of two sets or more than two. Second thing is, I give its notation before, like now, it's denoted by union. For example, I have two sets, one is A, another is B. So I will write A union B. This U represents union. Okay, then now it comes with the definition. So suppose we have two sets A and B. Then A union B contains those elements which are in A or B or both. So A union B will contain all those elements which are either in A, okay, which are either in A or in B or both. Okay, so let me make it more clear to you people. So for example, we have A is equivalent to 1, 2, 3, and say B is equivalent to A, 2, C. So A union B means it is a set of all the elements. A union B is again a set. Okay, it is a combination, or it is a collection. Collection is the right word. So it is a collection of all the elements which are in A. So that means 1, 2, 3, which are either in A or in B. So A, we have written all the elements, then B, A, 2, C, or in both, 2. Okay, so this is the definition. But now if you see here, we have written 2, 1, 2 and 3 times. So no need of repeating the elements. This is just I have written to make you understand that A union B means all the elements in A or in B. You have to consider all the elements in A or B. Okay, and then all the elements which are common to these two. So here basically A union B, how we will write it now. So we will remove this 2 and just we will write it once only. So the final answer will be like 1, then 3, then A, C and 2. See, the order of elements doesn't matter. You can write 2 first, 3 later, it doesn't matter. The only thing is we have to include all the elements from A, all the elements from B, and if there is some common, write it once only. So no element should be repeated. Okay, so this is your strategy, how you want to write them. This is about A union B. Let's do one more example. Suppose A is equivalent to P, Q and R, and B is equivalent to C, D and E. So here A union B. If you see here, there is no common element. So this is known as basically disjoint sets. They have no element in common. Okay, they have no element in common, so A and B will be called disjoint sets. Now here A is having elements P, Q and R. B is having elements C, D and E. So A union B means all the elements from A, then all the elements from P and all the common elements. Because it is disjoint, these are disjoint sets, so that means there will be no common element. So A union B means whatever its elements, they will be either from set A or from B or from the common elements for both of them. Okay, that's why we say either or means the elements in A union B will be either from the set A or from the set B or from their common part. Okay. Next comes intersection. Intersection is the second operation in the sets. It is always we can apply this operation when we have at least two sets or more than that. Okay. So we need at least two sets or more than two sets. Now it is represented by the notation like an N. A intersection B. Okay. When we say union, how you can memorize these letters? This is A union B. See, union word starts with U, so it is U. Intersection word ends with N, so it is like an N. Okay. You can apply any strategy to just memorize these things. Then comes A intersection B. So this is the notation, how to represent it. Now second thing comes definition. So A intersection means the common elements. Means A intersection B is a set that contains the elements which are both in set A and set B. So when AND comes, it is intersection. Okay, A intersection B means A and B, and this is A intersection B. Okay. And if it is in case of union, in case of union, what it comes with? In case of unions, it is like A union B or A or B or A union, you can write complete. Okay. So A union B means all the elements which are in A or B or common elements of A and B. Now example of A intersection B. For example, we have A is equivalent to 1, 2 and 3. B is equivalent to 2, C and D. So A intersection B means the elements which are common in both. So A and B, if you see, only one element. So A intersection B will be 2. Okay. Now here, suppose another example, A is say 2 and 6. B is say 1 and 4. So A intersection B, there is no common element. So A intersection B means an empty set, or you can say it is like, or we can write it something like phi to represent the null set or empty set. Okay. So next is the difference operation. Third operation is called difference operation. It is represented, the notation is minus sign. It is like A minus B, that means difference of A and B, or B minus A. They have different meanings. They are different. They are not same. Okay. So A minus B means only A. When you will go to the next topics in sets, you will see these kind of words written. Only A, only B. That means it's A only, no other set. Okay. Only those members of A which are not a part of any other set. So only A means, or you can say A minus B here, it means the elements of A but not B. Okay. For example, A is 1, 2 and 3. B is 2 and 4. So here what we have this element in common. But A minus B means only those elements of A which are not as a part of B. So we will write A minus B is just 1 and 3. You have to exclude all the common elements. In simple words, if you have to find out A minus B, so you have to write all the elements of the first set, whatever is written over here, and delete all the common elements of these two sets. Suppose I am saying B minus A. That means all the elements of B. So first write all the elements of B, that are 2 and 4. Then remove the common elements of B and A. So it is 2. So what we will do? We will remove this element. So B minus A is 4. Okay. Representation is this negative sign, minus sign. Examples I have explained. And A minus B means only A. It means the elements of A, no other elements, not B, which are not in B. Okay, you have to exclude all the common elements. Okay, next comes the practice question. Okay, the first question is, state whether the following are true or false. Alright, so A is given 5, 6 and 7. B is given 6, 8, 10, 12. So A union B is 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 12. Now here what we can do, we have to write A union B. So what you can do, you can write all the elements of A, then all the elements of B, and then common elements are already included in it. So we have to write those only one time. So 6 is here is a common element, so we will remove it. We'll just write it once. So we got 5, 6, 7 and then 8, 10, 12. Yeah, this statement is true. Second part is, P is equivalent to ABC, Q is equivalent to B, C and D. So you have to find P intersection Q. Intersection is like this, that means common elements. So here this is one common element and this is another common element. So B and C. Okay. Then third one is, union of two sets is the set of elements which are common to both of the sets. No, union means common elements plus elements in even only in A and elements in only B. Okay. Two disjoint sets have at least one element in common. No, when the two sets are disjoint, that means one is a set A and one is a set B. Okay. So that is not possible. That elements and they have no element in common. Disjoint sets, they don't have any element in common any time. Okay, you can take an example. For example, if a student is in school, okay, then it cannot be at home at the same time. So there is nothing common. Okay, or I want to give you some good example. For example, a person like a student who is opting BSc. Okay, there is two sets, BSc and BCom. Okay, or you can say one is BSc and one is MSc. It's better. One is BSc, one is MSc. They are not having anything common. Okay, so that way. There is no subject common in those two. Let's consider it in that way. Two overlap sets have all elements in common. I will explain it later, but two overlap means one set is there and it is overlapped by another one. So they have all elements in common. I will explain in the next video when we will do the Venn diagram and everything. Okay. Okay. Next is, let A, B, C be the three sets such that A, B and C is given. We have to find out A union B. So A union B means all the elements of A. And then B and common. So here what we can do, common is 12 is repeating 2 times, so common is automatically come, and 6 is also 2 times, so we will write it just once. So 6 and 12, just write once. So this is the A union B. A intersection B, the common elements, I think we removed 6 and 12, so 6 and 12 are the common elements. B intersection A is equal to A intersection B. They are same set. If you find A union B, it is similar to B union A. Only minus is not same. If you find B minus A and A minus B, they are not same. Okay, but B union A and A union B, they will be same. I'll discuss all these things more and more when we will go for the Venn diagrams and when we'll go for the notations. We represent all these sets in the form of like the Venn diagrams. Okay, and when we'll do the proving questions. Is A union B is equivalent to B union A? Of course it would be. Is B intersection C will be equal to B union C? See, here the signs are different, so they will not be same. Okay. Again the same thing. A is 1, 3, 7, 9, 10, 2, 5, 7 and all that. Different sets are given. We have to find A union B. I think these questions are quite easy to find out. Let's do a few of them. I do the last one. I think it will include many of the things from here. So it is A union B and then union A intersection B. Okay, so first I will find A union B. So A is 1, 3, 7, 9, 10. B is 2, 5. See, now instead of writing all the elements, I will see I have written first the elements of A. Now in order to write the elements of B, I will see if there is already some element written, I will not write it. Like 2 is there, okay, 5 is there, then 7. 7 is already written, so I will not write it. Then is 8, then is 9, 10. 10 is already there, so I will not write it. So this is my A union B. Then comes A intersection B. In intersection, which elements are common? 7 and 10. Now this is 1 and this is 2. Now what comes here? A union B union A intersection B. So A union B, this set, union with A intersection B. So we will write all these elements now. All the elements here and then these also. So 1, 3, 7, 9, 10, 2, 5, 8, 10. And after that 7 and 10 again. So 7 and 10 are already written. So no need to write them. So it's same thing. A union B union A intersection B. It will be simple A union B. So this is a very good property, that this will be equivalent to A union B. What happened here? I found A union B and I find the common element. See, A union B has everything. Okay. And when you will solve it, it will come out A union B only. Okay. Next, in this question, like they have asked, again they have given A, B and C, then find A union B, A union C and all that. So let's do the last question. Is A union B and this is equivalent to, so left hand side, A union B intersection A union C. Let's try it. So A union B, it's 2, 3, 4, 5, C, D, E, F. They're completely disjoint sets. There was nothing common. Then A union C. So 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we are finding its union with C. In C the first element is 4, which is already written, so no need to write again. 5 again written, then 6 and 7. Now we have to find out intersection of these two. So intersection means common elements. So common elements are only which one? A union B intersection A union C. Those will be 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay. Oh, sorry, it is intersection. I did the same correct, but I wrote wrong. So this we had to find out left hand side. Okay. Now comes the second part. A union B intersection C. So first of all, what is A? A is 2, 3, 4, 5, union B intersection C. In B and C, is there anything common? No. So that means that is an empty set. Now what is the union of these two? Union of these two means either the elements from here and here. Here is no element, so the union of these one will be. So that means this thing is equivalent to A union B intersection C. So what is written here? A union B intersection C. How you can expand it? It is A union B, then intersection again A union C. So A union will be with B and then A union will be with C. In this way you can remember these results. These results are very important to remember, and sometimes you will have to memorize it or sometimes you will have to prove it as well. Okay, but if you understand the basic definitions, then I think it would be quite easy for you people to do it. Same thing here, you have to find A intersection B, that means common elements. A intersection B, C, that means common elements in A and C. Then A intersection B, union A intersection C, easily you can evaluate it. Okay, I don't think there is need to explaining anything in this one. Let's randomly pick one of the questions, say fourth one. A intersection B, union C. So do it step by step. First find B union C. So I write all the elements of B. And then I have to write the elements from C. So it is B first element. Okay. B which is already written, so no need to write. F already written. And then G. And now A intersection. So A is what? A, B, C and D. We have to find the intersection between these two. So which are the common elements? One is C, another is D. Okay. So B union C and A's intersection with it is equivalent to C comma D. Just like this way we will write. Okay. Okay. Now next question. Now this question is. Okay. A is given, B is given, C is given. You have to find A intersection B. A intersection B means common elements in A and B. So which is like 3, 4 here and 3, 4 here. So 3, 4. Then B intersection C. B intersection C means common elements of B and C, which is 4 and 5. Next is B minus C. That means all the elements of B. First write how to evaluate it. See, just write the, see the technology, see the way. Write all the elements of B. 3, 4, 5. And what are the elements of C? Just write the common elements of B and C first. Always do like this. That is 4 and 5. So B minus C means all the elements of B, nothing of common. So just cancel these. So what is left there? 3. So that means this is B minus C. That means only the elements B only, no other. So B means minus C means only the elements of B, and exclude whichever the elements of C are present in B. Okay, I rewrite this statement. Okay, I write here B minus C means write only elements of B and exclude if any element of C is present in B. That means if any element is common, remove it. So B minus C means it is B minus B intersection C. Okay. So whatever the element of B, you have to write all of them. And then whatever is the common thing between these two sets, just remove it. Okay. If suppose you have A minus C, that means write all elements of A. And then whatever the elements of A and B, sorry, A and C, just remove them. Okay, so this is the way. And now in the last, it's a quiz time, so you have to do all of these questions. Union of each of the section A, B are given, and then in the second part They said x is a natural number, and see, this is which form? Set builder form. They have given the rule. They have not listed the elements of the sets like before. Like this is which method? Tabular method, listing method, roster method. But in this case, if I have to form second one, x is such that x is a natural number. Natural number means 1, 2, 3, 4. But x should be greater than 3. So that means 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Less than equal to 9. So we can take 9 as well. So A is this. D is again a set of natural numbers between 10 to 15. So greater than 10 means it should be 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. Okay, and then you can find out union. So union will be A union B. These are completely disjoint sets because there is nothing common. So A union B means all the elements in A, then B and then common. So but we, this way there is no common element. Rest of the questions you can do on your own. It is for the practice. Okay, I hope this video is clear to you. So just practice these questions and let's wait for the next video. I'm going to explain the rest of the things. For example, the interval notations will be the next topic. Equivalent sets, what is the difference between equal sets and equivalent sets, and then proving questions, and then the main topic, the very main topic in sets, Venn diagrams. Okay, enjoy this video. If any doubts, you can comment, give comment in the comment box. You can text me, WhatsApp me, anything. Thank you.